Should a math book cost $180? Well, if you ask a certain professor at the Cal State University of Fullerton, it should absolutely not. The professor's name is Alain Bourget, who is a math professor at Cal State Fullerton. Originally, this the new version of the textbook that he's told to use costs $180. And he was like, that's ridiculous. I'm going to use two separate textbooks that together cost $75. So I'm going to go around the system. Now, he was admonished by the school, and he faces certain potential negative consequences to this decision that include not getting raises in the future or never becoming a full professor. There's a lot riding on this. According to Nicole Allen from Inside Higher Ed, she says, 10 years ago, long-term departmental adoptions were considered good for affordability, since it allowed a strong local used book market to develop. Now it can work against students by perpetuating the traditional publishing industry's stranglehold on the market, which keeps new innovations like OER out, referring to open educational resources. According to Alain Bourget, he says, get off my back. I think that's Alan in French. He says, if the university thinks you're good enough to teach the course, they should let you pick the materials. And then from the open education group, David Wiley from BYU, he says, when faculty identify a textbook of equal quality that is significantly less expensive than the textbook currently in use, that creates the ethical imperative for department leaders to revisit their previous adoption. Now, there are certain other factors at play in here, such as this professor, the professors at the university wrote the book.
Yeah.
So it's possible that there's something out there like that. But the faculty and the university point out, no, that's not necessarily the case.
No, they can say that.
There are other universities that use this book. And then there's nearly 70 faculty colleagues have signed a petition saying that the reprimand that they gave to Bourget should be withdrawn. Mm. Where do we come down on this? Because it's so expensive to buy textbooks.
Those fuckers.
In the math department specifically?
No. The textbooks in general, that industry where it promotes the most massively overpriced book in the world, and you spend a lifetime paying it off, you just roll it into like a student loan-esque type.
Yeah.
I hate it. I went to GW, overpriced. I wish I could, honestly, I probably would have done that a little differently. But
if you could pick
a
different
everywhere.
University named after a president, which would you pick?
Okay.
So I think it's crazy that you go to college to learn about the real world and to get all this experience that you're then going to go out and use in your real life. But it's so different. When was the last time anybody watching this spent $180 on a book?
Seriously.
You would never, ever do that for the rest of your life. I buy books. I wouldn't spend more than $15 on a book ever. But for some reason, you're supposed to do it 6 or 7 times per semester and then do it over and over and over again. Because
is
the money is
more?
Supposed to not be real. It's just,
right.
Oh, I'll pay that off some other year.
That's exactly.
This is an introductory linear algebra and differential equations course. This is my point. If it's a textbook that required millions of dollars of research to find the findings on, but no, this is the introduction to algebra.
Yeah.
Like, do we need to spend $180 on this? I know what it is. It's the publishing companies trying to, it's a racket. Someone interviewed in this process said it's an absolute racket and we can't let it keep going.
Now, I get the argument that if you're going to have multiple sections, you would want the books to be the same. I understand that. I would say that you should balance that against other concerns like saving $110 and still getting roughly the same education. The idea that linear algebra, I don't think, was invented in the last year or two. I imagine there are a lot of books that you could learn it from.
Lines have been around for a very long time.
They've been around forever.
Algebra, I think, was invented in ancient Persia.
Is that true?
Yeah.
That sounds good then.
Algebra.
But also, again, it's not just the $180. It's the fact that I think it's the only, other than people getting onto planes, up until recently when now you can use your electronic devices and you'd read books, you don't need books and anything else. The idea that we still haven't been able to transition past books to, like he's trying to do, at least in part, putting together a book out of free materials, That needs to be the standard. These books, look, I am sorry if more publishing houses go under. Mm-hmm. I want there to still be publishing. I like reading books. But this is not one area that needs to be protected. They have had a monopoly over this material and have been able to charge whatever they want for years. And they have been, perhaps as much as any other group, responsible for the huge amount of student loan debt that we have. Thousands of dollars every person has is because of these bullshit books that are overpriced. And it needs to end. And if it takes one math teacher to help contribute to that, he is a hero, goddammit, just like this thing in back of me says.